Ensonglopedia of the human episode
1. John! Psst. Hey, John!
Oh, hello.
John, what are you doing?
Loading the dishwasher?
But it's the middle of the day. Usually you're off somewhere. Why are you always here?
Coronavirus?
What?
There's an international pandemic. Coronavirus. What, haven't you heard? Where have you been?
Toaster?
Look, we're in lockdown. We have to stay indoors so we don't spread the virus.
Oh, should I be worried?
I don't know. What species are you?
I don't know. What species are you?
Human?
Huh. And what's one of them then?
Well, it's... like, it's one of... me?
So you consider yourself to be a prime example of humanhood, do you?
No, I didn't say that.
You represent the epitome of your species, do you?
No, it's... Well, a human is... Well, a human's like... Alright, I'm human because I gestated in the womb of another human, and so did my mum, and so did her mum, and so did her mum, and...
You did what in a human's what?
A gestated, I got that. Gestated.
What was that like?
I can't remember.
Well, I could help you remember.
No, please don't do that.
Look into
no.
my eyes.
No, please, I don't want to go back there. No, no,
you
no, please, no, no, I don't want to, no, don't make me, no, don't make me come back, no.
Everything that I had and everything I was to become was contained in the DNA in a sperm from my dad and an egg from my mom. For 10 weeks that sperm had been waiting its turn. Now its moment was here and its goal was so near. The egg was a lot older than you might assume. It had been around since my mom was inside my grandma's womb. The other sperms gave chase in the fallopian race, but my sperm won first place. The egg and sperm fuse, and the resulting zygote cruise through the fallopian tubes for a couple of days. The cells inside it divided till at last that ball collided with the wall of the uterus around a 5. I was barely alive, and already I'd had quite an egg. My cells were by now fated to be differentiated, destined to become my blood, kidney and nerves. And I was so happy when at around 8:10 I grew a new outer shell with super sleek curves. I was alright, Jack. I was jacked up in my amniotic sack. Begun, but it's still 9 months before I'll see the sun. And anyway, I don't even have any eyes yet. I am the bun in the oven of fun. Well, it might be fun if I had a brain big enough to analyze it. I don't yet have a sign of the zodiac. Not while I'm shacked up in my amniotic sack. At 22 days, my heart starts to beat. A sound that'll spend the rest of my life on repeat. From 5 weeks I have an umbilical cord through which all of the goodness I need can be poured. But around the same time my limbs start to grow, and the cleft between my brain and my sphere starts to show. The Y chromosomes, SRY genus just made me a male. I'm now 10 weeks old, look, my first fingernail. I cannot write a treatise, for I am still a fetus. No rent is due from my womb with a view. I can afford to be slack, shacked up in my amniotic sack. What matter replaces this world into which I will soon be hurled? Such questions can wait, for now life is pretty great. There is nothing that I lack while I'm shacked up in my amniotic sack. Please don't tell me this is some sort of flashback. Take me back to my amniotic sack.
That was very weird.
So, that's what makes you human, is it? Being in a womb like that?
Well, no, interestingly, there's quite a lot of disagreement over the exact moment you become human or become alive, whether it's when you're conceived or when you're born or somewhere in the between, like after 23...
Basically, whichever way you look at it, once you're born, then you're definitely human, is that it?
I suppose so.
So, what was that like then?
What like then?
Birth.
I can't remember.
You are feeling peculiar.
No, no, please don't make me go back. No, anything but birth. Please, no, I can't take it. No, please, birth. I don't want birth. No.
Birth, what's it worth? It's hardly love, a minute mirth. Trying to fit my girth through your bum, mum. Birth, take the strain and laughing gas to allay the pain as I squeeze my massive brain through your bum, mum. Oh, what do you mean? That's not your bum. I might be young, but I'm not that dumb. Oh, there's a hole between the holes through which you poo and through which you pee, out of which pops me. Isn't it a pity birth's not more pretty, and that their hole is so itty-bitty? But isn't it rad that this little lad will finally get to hang out with his mum and dad? But isn't it crazy that of all species we may be the only ones who need medical help to have a baby? But isn't it brill that with modern midwife skill in this day and age, birth's less likely to kill? But isn't it a shame we don't all suffer the same, and the one who takes the brunt of the pain is the dame? But isn't it grand that help is at hand for my mum, who gets an oxytocin hit from her pituitary gland? Birth, it's the first chance I get to see the earth, but it's unfortunate the first sight I get is of your bum, mum.
Enough of that foul language, thank you very much.
Your fault, you did your wibbly wobbly thing.
So, is it just humans that get born then?
No, I think it's all mammals, is that right?
So that's not what makes you special?
Well, I didn't say we were special, I just...
I asked you what a human is, and you gave me what is quite clearly an incomplete and unsatisfactory answer.
Well, all right, look. To be human means, at its core, that you... Hello? Animations, eh? It's an interesting question, though. What does it mean to be human?
Ensonglopedia.